architecture ideas. They cannot compete with the multimedia technology in which a lot of colorful presentations are there, sound presentations are there. See, there is sound trick and there is visual effects, and there is a multifaceted presentation, colorful and attractive presentation in multimedia tools like e-learning, distance learning, then visual communication systems, objective learning, EduSat methodologies of teaching. Innumerable technologies have come. Recently there was a paper made by J. E. Burgess with which he has clearly quoted, now we have to remove all these teachers. Teachers should be sent out of the schools, that should be only computers. There should be some teachers for clarifications of doubts occasionally. Most of the descriptive instruction methodologies should be carried only by computers and modern media tools. Our system is totally to avoid all of these machines and unwanted things to throw out and get all the colors you are getting from the media to get the same colors from a radiant spiritual master. The problem with the spiritual master is, one, he is not so able to possess or to show all of these colors by which he can attract and command the student. The type of commanding and attractive radiant personality is not there in the teacher. Second thing, even if it is shown, the students are non-receptacles so that they cannot understand the radiations of the masters. So unless there is a radiation receptivity as well as a radiation productivity is created between the masters, I think that computer is going to take the role of all masters, and there will be only machine and students communicating with each other. At first it was great Mahapurushas. First M was Maharishi. Second M was masters. Even first thing was Maharishi. Second M was masters. Now just men, they are not masters. Just human beings are there in the pretext of teachers, in the form of teachers. Now even that M will be eroded, and there will be the final M known as a machine. They are going to communicate with the fourth M, Dushta Chatushtaya. But that is not Dushta Chatushtaya. That is Upaya Chatushtaya, in which there is Dushta Dvita and Shishta Dvita. Maharishis and masters, acharyas, are known as Shishta Dvitas. And just the human beings, men and machines, they are known as Dushta Dvitas. Combining together, it is known as Upaya Chatushtaya. So this is what we are going to say. So Shastra say that they have to do Upadesha in the ear. That is Karna Bodha. They have to write the I or am in the tongue. That is known as Jihva Lekana or Akshara Lekana. They have to catch the fingers of the child and write as Hari Om or Om or something else. It is Akshara Lekana. So Akshara Lekana, Karna Bodha and Akshara Upadesha. These things are being done in our ancestral period by which proper knowledge initiation. This everybody can do. Anybody can catch a child's finger and write R, A, R, Om, anything you can do. But a potential person, a radiant person, a permeating person should do that so that it will take the atmosphere. Benefits will be assured for the child to develop in future. So this is known as Vidyaramba, in which a tongue, finger and ear, they are sanctified, purified and hypervigorated to have the most possible means of knowledge and to give the most possible products in society for its development. Then it is Uparayana. Uparayana is the existing samskara. That's what I told. Most of the samskaras are not there. They are known as Kali Vajjya. Something we cannot do in Kali Yuga. They are known as Kali Vajjya. Second thing is Ajnata. We don't know the names of the samskaras at all. They are known as Ajnata. They are known as Ajnata. And third thing, the samskaras are there. We know them, but we are not practicing. They are known as parityaktas. The third thing, they are known as parityaktas. The fourth thing, sankshiptas. We are doing, like vivaha, we are doing just for 2 or 3 hours. That is known as sankshipta. Asara, we are doing something, but having no meaning at all. That is known as asara. Alankarika means, we are doing, see, that is a sugar-coated medicine. Medicine has drug content more and the sugar content just for giving you an initial taste. There is a small taste of sugar. If you are taking a drug coated sugar tablet, how will be the efficacy of the tablet? Instead of taking a sugar coated drug, if you are taking a drug coated sugar tablet, will it come for rescue? Alankara's video is there, reception is there, feast is there, cultural program, orchestra, these things are alankaras. And they should be like a sugar coated tablet in which drug content is more and sugar content is less. They should be just accessories to the main rituals. Rituals are there in various forms like Vara Nirnaya, Vara Nikshana, Samikshana, Lagna Patrika, Nishchidartha, Muhurta Nishchaya, Muhurta Danda Nishchaya, Kankana, Raksha, Vrata Sankalpa, Ubhaya Vrata Sankalpa, Moola Dravya Dana, Shubha Vastu Anayana, Muhurta Uttapana, Hasta Grahana, Hritaya Sparsha, Parikrama, Upavesha, Laja Homa, Prajavati Homa, Atithi Homa, Ashma Rohana, Arundhiti, Dhruva, Saptariti, Pradarshana, Griha Pravesha, Upasamvesha, innumerable things are there in marriage. All of these things are available. provided orchestra, dance, videography. So how can you expect a prolonged life? Somebody, they were celebrating the silver jubilee celebrations. After a few years, if successfully a couple can live together for 1 year, it is going to be a very big celebration. There are three things I want to say. I don't want this type of feminism or this type of patriotism. I want a recent combination between two. I don't want either extremities. These female beings are totally suppressed. I don't want, in the context of feminism and its uprising, I don't want this type of total anarchy in the society also. There are three potencies in marriage. Number one, cultivation of qualities. Cultivation of qualities. Puna bija vedana. Second thing is swaparivartana, in which self-transformation in the form of adjustment, realization, mutual forgiving and forgetting things. That is swaparivartana. Third thing is the very great potency by which the honor of each and everybody can be protected, well nourished by the other. So married couple, due to that sankalpa or the mantra, they are having three potencies. If it is properly done, there are two things. Even for adjustable things, now there is a conflict. Conflict results in clash. Clash because of ego, that results in separation, divorcing, or useless lives that will affect the wholesome generation. The forefathers are the departed people, they will be also captivated. The successors will also be demoralized. So there is a system of adjustment. That type of adjustment should spring from an egoless mind. But adjustment should be applied in some area. Then transformation should be applied in some area. So if your husband is doing wrong or otherwise, there is a type of adjustment where it is possible. That type of adjustment is not adjustment of an imbecile. That is a divine adjustment by which a person, by means of a divine practice or vrata, submits the burden to a God, by which the person is very capably handled by God himself so that he is transformed. This type of adjustment because of no hope or no other goal is useless. Vedas give such a type of adjustment not the basis on your destiny. Oh, na vidhi adhi, nen atlane undi kottam. It is not like that. Vedas, they give such an adjustment by which, as it is something which is handed to the devatas, with whose sakshi this marriage has been performed, it is the duty of the divine governance to take care of this issue. So such a type of divine submission or entrustment of the job to a capable, concerned senior or superior, making the job very perfectly done where he could not do or she could not do, is known as divine adjustment. That is known as entrustment, number one. And number two, transformation. By means of a really capable person's prayer, the other person is transformed. That is also there. So wherever we need somebody else to transform, we can pray for them. Wherever we need to be transformed for understanding them. See, wherever there is a problem, I have been discussing with parents who have brought their child, and they wanted me to give some advice to the child. I also interrogated the child, later realized that really the parents, they need my advice. So whenever we are blaming somebody, we have to think that there may be a possible problem or deficiency within ourselves, which we may not know, which we may know, but we are not courageous enough to, we are not masculine enough to accept it. We are not bold enough to accept it. So this marriage bondage made by our shastras, they create three wonders. Number one, if you are wrong, it will transform your mind. Number two, if it is naturally adjustable on limited grounds, it will create adjustment. Wherever it is not adjustable, transformation. Wherever it is not transformed, it is neither be transformed, near adjustment is okay, adjustment. Third thing is divine protection. A Mangala Sutra is a remote for the husband. And no doubt it is also wrongly operated as a remote in most of the houses. I am not mentioning that. Most of the women still, they are holding remote control of the husband. I am not talking about the hand-packed systems. I am just talking about a system where a person, a really capable person, can handle a Mangala Sutra. And bearing a Mangala Sutra is the wife. And those who offer the Mangala Sutra, they are the male community. Both of them can use the Mangala Sutra as a common tool. Mangala Sutra is a common tool. If the wife is not pure, if she is arrogant, if she is adamant, if she is totally aberrant in nature, the husband with the same Mangala Sutra, by Duranmaya, he can create some wonders. By Sparshanmaya, Sannihitanmaya, the